Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Avril McNeill, head teacher, Glenrothes High School.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and Jenny Gilruth for nominating me here today. Whilst considering what to share with Parliament, serendipity aligned when given the date to deliver time for reflection, as it coincides with International Women's Day, celebrated this week on the 8th of March. International Women's Day not only celebrates women of various political, social and economic standing, it is rooted in striving for equality and honours those who campaigned for women's rights. The aim of equality requires a collaborative effort. And so, I would ask that Parliament takes time this week, as I have done, to reflect upon the women who have impacted significantly upon our lives, and how they have helped shape our values and our thinking over time. As someone who grew up in working-class Renfrewshire during the 1980s and 90s, I will always be grateful to Pat Cunningham, my history teacher. She inspired me to be the first woman in my family to go to university. Her knowledge and passion for history and politics, twinned with her quirky humour and dress sense, encouraged me to be aspirational and to develop a strong social conscience. From Pat Cunningham, not only did I learn to love the suffrage movement, who secured the franchise for women, she influenced my path towards becoming a teacher of modern studies, history, and ultimately a head teacher. If Emmeline Pankhurst were addressing Parliament today, as she did in 1912, she would incite this meeting to rebellion. Presiding Officer, please rest assured that is not my intention today. As a student teacher in 1995, at the same time as genocide was occurring in Srebrenica, I would teach pupils in modern studies about the Balkan crisis and about Sarajevo sparking the Great War in history. In 2018, I was privileged to form part of an all-women delegation visiting Bosnia on behalf of Remembering Srebrenica Scotland. Whilst there, we met Dr. Branka, founder of an NGO named Power of Women, who support victims of rape camps that existed during the Balkan crisis. Dr. Branka had the most profound effect on me, having given her free time for almost 30 years to support the holistic health and repatriation of Bosniak women. She empowered survivors to move away from objectification and dehumanisation towards a sense of independence, pride and purpose in running their own cooperative. All of these women helped shape my moral purpose. But who have shaped yours? Please take time this week to reflect upon this. Thank you.
Thank you.